we want to find the limits of the composite functions based upon the graphs of f of x and g of x. Our first limit is the limit as x approaches negative infinity of g of f of x. So we'll start by considering what's happening to f of x, the inner function, as x approaches negative infinity. So here's the graph of f of x. As x approaches negative infinity, we'd be moving left along the graph, and notice how the function values are approaching the horizontal asymptote of y equals 1 from values of y that are less than 1. And since we have a composite function where the outputs of f become the inputs into g, that means this limit is equal to the limit as x approaches positive 1 from the negative side of the outer function g of x. Again, since the function values of f are approaching positive 1 from values that are less than 1, these become the inputs into the outer function g, so our limit becomes the limit as x approaches positive 1 from the negative side of g of x. And now looking at the graph of g of x, we'll approach positive 1 from the negative side to determine our limit. As we approach positive 1 from the negative side, we're approaching x equals 1 along here, and we can see we're approaching the function value of 0, and therefore the limit of our composite function is 0. Now we'll consider the limit as x approaches positive infinity of g of f of x. So again, we'll first consider what's happening to f of x approaches positive infinity. So as we move to the right along the graph of f, notice how we're still approaching the function value of 1, but now it's going to be from the positive side of 1, or from values that are greater than 1. And since these function values become the inputs into function g, this is equal to the limit as x approaches positive 1 from the positive side of g of x. So now looking at the graph of g of x, as we approach positive 1 from the positive side or right side, we're now approaching positive 1 from this direction. And again, notice how we're still approaching the function value of 0. Therefore, the limit of this composite function is also 0. Next, we have the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive side or right side of g of f of x. So now determining what's happening to f of x as x approaches 0 from the right side or positive side. Here's the graph of f. As we approach 0 from the right side, we're moving along the graph in this direction here. And notice how the function values are increasing without bound. And these function values become the inputs into our outer function g, which means this is equal to the limit as x approaches positive infinity of the outer function g of x. So now going back to the graph of g, as x approaches positive infinity, we're moving right along the graph, and the graph does continue to move upward, and therefore this limit will approach positive infinity, which remember does not exist. And now for our last limit, we have the limit as x approaches negative 1 from the negative side or left side of g of f of x. So again, we'll first consider what's happening to function f as x approaches negative 1 from the left side. So as we're approaching x equals negative 1 from the negative side or left side, we're moving along the graph in this direction here, and we're approaching the function value of 0 from values that are greater than 0 because we're above the x-axis, which means this is going to be equal to the limit as x approaches 0 from the positive side of the outer function g of x. So now looking at the graph of g of x, as we approach x equals 0 from the positive side, we're moving in this direction along the graph, and notice how the function values are going down without bound, and therefore this limit is equal to negative infinity, which again does not exist. Okay, that's going to do it for these four examples. I hope you found this helpful.